Hi, my name is Felix from Milliwatt Infrastructure. I'm the core developer here and specialized in creating Terraform modules and serverless Node.js applications. You can find me on Twitter or GitHub by my username ofhouse. Feel free to reach out for any questions. Links are also available in the description of this video. Today, I want to show you the latest iteration of our serverless deployment toolkit Terraform Next.js for Amazon Web Services. It enables you to host Next.js apps serverless on your own AWS account by creating the necessary infrastructure for you. With the upcoming 1.0 release, we finally enable you to create multiple Next.js deployments under the same CloudFront distribution. Before we jump right in, let's take a quick look at a previous version of our module. You might remember it from the following architecture diagram that was posted on our blog. Here you can see the resources that were created when using the former release. It has global resources that are initially created like the CloudFront content delivery network or as free buckets that don't change with every update of your app. The actual code of your Next.js application is split between Lambda functions that are responsible for the server-side rendering and static files that are uploaded into the S3 bucket. This way, requests for JavaScript or CSS files can be directly served from S3 and require no Lambda invocation. When updating your app, Terraform will check if the content of the functions or the static files have changed and then performs an update on them. So, the deployment workflow then has two steps. First, build the Next.js app with the tfnext command line interface locally and then run the Terraform apply command to update the stack with the new Lambda functions and static files. While this workflow is easy to use for most of our early users, it has some drawbacks. Especially when your app or team grows. So when you need multiple environments like development, testing, and production, you always have to duplicate the whole stack for each of these. Or when deploying a new version of your app and something goes wrong, a rollback always requires a full build and stack update. This costs valuable time when you try to restore your app into a working state. And lastly, there's no way to create preview deployments you know from other providers like AWS Amplify, Netlify or Vercel. So that's why we introduced some fundamental changes to the architecture of this module that I think you will love. Let's take a first look at the updated architecture. As you can see, we have a better separation of global things like CloudFront and deployment resources like Lambda functions. Instead of using Terraform to create the Lambda functions for each deployment, we now use a CDK construct internally which creates a new CloudFormation stack for every deployment. This allows us to create a technically unlimited number of parallel deployments with this system. Each deployment now creates an entry in a routing table and the lambda@edge function is responsible to route the traffic to the correct deployment based on the hostname. So let's say a new HTTP request for app.example.com comes in, the Lambda function is triggered. It then looks up which deployment is currently linked to this hostname and redirects the request to the correct Lambda function or S3 file. The workflow for setup and deployment has also changed. Terraform now only comes into play for the initial setup but is not required thereafter. This has the advantage that you can leave the setup of the Terraform module to your IT department and your developers can focus on the deployment. The deployment is now packaged into a new workflow that uses the tfnext CLI. Besides the existing build command, a new command for deployment has been added. When running the tfnext deploy command, it then communicates through an internal API with the Terraform module and creates a new stack of Lambda functions for the deployment. The API itself is fully secured and can only be accessed with AWS credentials. After the deployment is done, a unique deployment alias domain is assigned to it. With this alias domain, you can then directly visit the new deployment from your browser. Okay, now let's see it in action and how all of this works together. To get started, let's visit the GitHub repository of the module. Link to to it is available in the video description. And let's go down to the requirements. We need to have Terraform installed here. And we need to have Node installed here. We also need a system that supports Bash and Curl, so Windows is not supported for now. And we also need a Route53 hosted zone registered into our AWS account. For this example, we use our basic domain mili.is, and we need that as a custom domain for a CloudFront distribution here. Okay, so let's start by setting up the Terraform module itself. We can copy the code, the example code from here. Then let's create a new folder called Terraform. Go into it with the code editor. And then we can create a new file called main.tf. Paste the code here. And yeah, let's make some adjustments here. First, we need to define where most of the resources should be created. I live close to the city of Frankfurt here in Germany, so I use EU Central 1. The rest is okay. So now we need to define the custom domain where the Next.js apps should be deployed to. In this case, we choose demo.mili.js. And here we need to set the hosted zone, which is mili.is. And this one looks all okay. And here we can give it a custom name, let's say demo. And all resources that the Terraform module will create will then be prefixed by this deployment name later. Okay, the rest looks fine. Let's bring it on to our AWS account. All resources that are created by the module should cause no costs when you're running in the free tier. So you would don't need to worry about any hidden costs that come to you at this point. Let's bring it on by running Terraform init. It will now download our module here and all of its dependencies. Takes a little while. And after that we can run Terraform apply command to push all the resources to our AWS account. Confirm it with yes, and now our resources are created in our AWS account. This takes a little while, so let's skip ahead. Now our resources are successfully created in our AWS account. We can now copy the API endpoint here that we need later, and policy ARN here. Okay, that's for the Terraform part. Let's start by deploying some Next.js apps now. Before we do this, let's create a new AWS user which only has access to our internal API here. So let's switch to the AWS console. Access here, and then attach the policy, which is this, review, manage policy, okay, create user, and now we get the access key and the secret access key here. We can then save this to an AWS profile on our local machine. When we have the AWS CLI installed, we can run AWS prepare profile, set a name for the profile, which is demo in this case, and then copy over the access key and the secret access key. Leave this empty, and now we are ready to deploy our first app. Let's start with one of the official examples from the Next.js repo, in this case the Hello World example. Let's copy this. Open a new editor. And then we need to install our CLI, which is done by npm install global tf next add canary. Because the 1.0 release is not yet released, we need to use the canary version here. And now we have access to npm next to our console, and we start by building a project, which is done by running tf next build. This prepares the Next.js app for the deployment, and to the deploy we need to run tf next deploy with the endpoint we got installation here, and to authenticate we use the profile that we created. Okay, now uploads and creates the deployment, and after it is finished you get an URL where the deployment is available from the browser. Here you have the Hello World example. To make this available under another domain, we can use tf next alias, and then we can say the domain we want for this deployment, which is demo.me.is, and link to this deployment. After that you see it is also available under demo.mini.s. Let's check out another example that actually uses Lambda roots. This will take a little bit longer because in the background a CloudFormation template is now created, and CloudFormation is not that fast in deployment, but we are working on it to make it faster. Okay, now let's check the deployment. It takes a little bit longer because the Lambda
parameter functions are invoked. But after you reload, you see the all lambdas are wrong, and everything works smooth. To clean up everything that we created, let's run which shows us all deployments that are currently active, and then we can destroy these by tfnext deployment help. And the other deployment because we have created a custom alias for it, which is demo.mili.is, we cannot remove this deployment, and we have to remove the alias before it. So rtfnext alias to show all aliases that are associated with a deployment, we can run tfnext alias ls, which shows us our custom alias here. And to remove this, we can run tfnext alias rm. Now the alias is removed, and we then can run tfnext again, and now the deployment is also removed. We can check if all deployments are successfully removed by running tf deployment ls again, and as you can see, no deployments are on our AWS account anymore. Last thing is to destroy the Terraform module we created. For this, you will simply have to Terraform destroy. And now everything that was created for this tutorial is removed completely from your AWS account.
That's it for today. Hope you liked the video, and see you soon for the next update.